Hey guys, this is Austin, and today I'm here with a review of Corel VideoStudio Pro X5. This is the latest version of the software I've used to edit my videos for nearly 2 years now, and there's a lot I like about VideoStudio. If you've never tried it before, you'll find it's a very simple to use editor that has support for multiple audio and video tracks, picture-in-picture editing, chroma keying, and much more. One of my favorite new features is the ability to record a screencast from inside VideoStudio. Head over to the Capture tab and then select Screen Capture. You can record the full screen, an individual program, or a custom-sized area with options to record Windows audio along with a microphone, and it supports multiple monitors. Quality is good, although file sizes are quite large in the WMV format. It's great for doing normal screencasts, and you can even record gameplay footage if you like, although Fraps is still probably a better option for fast-paced gameplay. Another new feature is the ability to pull multi-layer images from PaintShop Pro and be able to edit each individual layer, which can be nice if you want to tweak a composition. Another feature is being able to export HTML5 interactive videos. It exports the video in both H.264 as well as WebM, and packages it all up for use on the web. While not something a lot of people will use, this is one of the more unique features of VideoStudio X5. It also now supports up to 60p footage, which works nicely with the time-lapse features. While the last version wasn't bad as far as performance goes, X5 is a noticeable step forward. Using my editing rig, which consists of a Core i7-2600K at 4GHz, 16GB of RAM, and 120GB solid-state drive, the program easily keeps up with my normal 720p video editing, and even kept going when I tossed a few 1080p clips into the timeline. That's not something you can do with many other editors, regardless of how powerful your computer is. Memory usage is also solid, with most projects using less than 1GB of RAM. If you've got an older computer, VideoStudio still has you covered with Smart Proxy, which can automatically make smaller clips to use with editing and then render in full high definition. The overall interface is very similar to X4 and is set up like most modern video editors, with a preview window, clip bin, and timeline, with a storyboard option for easier use. All your other features carry over as well, including chroma key support, DVD and Blu-ray burning, stop motion video, a wide variety of formats available for export, and much more. 3D support has also been improved, with the ability to edit MPO 3D pictures from cameras, as well as 3D AVI video, which makes this the first editor that I've seen that can actually use both the 3D stills and video from the Nintendo 3DS. It's nothing for me to sit down and edit a video for several hours at a time most days, so I really need a solid video editor that has what I need. While the screencasting features have replaced another program in my workflow, I am still using After Effects to supplement some higher-end features such as motion tracking. All things considered though, Corel VideoStudio Pro X5 definitely remains my video editor of choice, and something I highly recommend to anyone who's serious about video editing. VideoStudio Pro X5 is available for download on Windows starting today on Corel's website, for $80 or $60 as an upgrade from X3 or X4, and will be hitting stores in boxed form March 21st. There's also a full-featured 30-day trial with no watermarks or restrictions available at the site, so if you're interested, give it a shot and see how you like it. If you enjoyed, definitely be sure to leave this video a thumbs up, and if you're interested in more videos like this, be sure to subscribe.